podcast of Cleveland Indians franchise and MLB The Show 17. Hopefully everybody here had a great winter and you're ready to go here with another franchise long or season long or whatever you want to call it. What our plan is going to be today here is I am going to play this first game and then we'll try and quick manage the rest of the series against Texas and even Arizona, time permitting, and then starting next week we'll get into the series against the White Sox and the Tigers. Looks like Corey Kluber and Yu Darvish are going to be our starting pitching matchup for today. I believe that's tomorrow night's matchup as well. I'll wear the alternate uniforms. I do play with the quick counts feature on it. It's going to be an MLB Network game. So let's go ahead and play. And the lineup looks alright. Alright. So let's go ahead and play and we'll talk to you here in a little bit.
MLB Network brings you baseball from North Central Texas as we get a look inside Globe Life Park. Opening night here in this brand new season between the Cleveland Indians and the Texas Rangers. Hello again, everybody. Baseball is back. Welcome to our special opening day broadcast on MLB Network. I'm joined by Dan Plesac, and Dan, as we get things going this season, it's pitching that has to be key if this team's going to have success.
Just like any team, pitching is going to be a key factor for this ball club as the year plays out. I'm sure the staff will have its ups and downs, but if they can pitch like they can, I think this team is going to be pretty successful.
It's a date that's been circled for weeks, and it's finally here. Opening night on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. To erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your 2017 Texas Rangers.
Quickly now, a look at the two men who are entrusted with the starting pitching assignment here to begin the new year. Now a moment here for the Indians' starting lineup. Harold, what's their focus as they go for their first win?
Matt, this is going to be a pitcher's duel. I mean, both these guys have a chance to work deep in the game. They've shown they can do that. Runs are a premium. I think if you don't get them early, we may not see a lot of runs in this game at all.
Yu Darvish gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
Let's take a look at the defense for the Rangers, brought to you by Majestic. I'm looking at Rougned Odor. I love this guy. Not tall, stands about 5'6", but man, does he have some kind of power and the ability to play with that fire within him. He's an intense player and a competitor.
Here's Michael Brantley. He'll begin things here against Yu Darvish. Set to deliver on 2-1. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. Here it is. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Point.
Alright, a hit. I see somebody just joined me, so thank you for joining me. We just got underway. Did I make a pretty dumb decision right there? I'm not sure what happened here to the sound, so you'll have to bear with me, but thank you for joining us.
And he makes the catch for the second out.
Batting fifth, first baseman, Chris Colabello.
Digging in, Chris Colabello. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Left side. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Indians strand a couple. Now the Rangers will get their first crack scoreless.
Well, if I wouldn't have made it.
Now time now to look at Jeff Bannister's Rangers lineup card in this one. Danny, any thoughts?
Yeah, keep an eye on Elvis Andrus. This guy hit over 300 last year, and man, it was impressive. Just hitting over 300 is really something special to look at. He's a consistent hitter. I love watching his approach. He doesn't make a lot of mistakes. He'll be there again this year if he continues to stay within himself.
Corey Kluber is on the mound for the season opener on the road in this one. HR, what's the word on him?
This guy struck out over 200 batters last year, and the one thing I like is when he gets two strikes on a guy, how he approaches them. I want to see if I can learn something watching this guy pitch today. Very excited to see him get somebody in a two-count strike and watch him put them away. All right, here's how the Indians line up defensively, brought to you by Majestic. And behind the plate, Yan Gomes. You know, he calls one of the best games in baseball. He's got a great pitching staff to work with. But the thing I like about him, he will throw to different bases. And he can only do that because he's got such good footwork.
Here's Elvis Andrus now. He'll start things out here against Corey Kluber. Here it comes now to Andrus. Ripped down the first baseline. That's a hit, their first of the new season. He's through first and hustling for second. Elvis is still going. He's headed for third. And he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed.
And the home crowd is absolutely eating this up. Let off the home half of the first with a triple, and they're applying the pressure right from the get-go.
In now, Carlos Gomez. Called strike two on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2.
Oh, that's for sure going to be a pitch he wants back. You're not going to get many balls right in the wheelhouse from a top-level arm like this.
He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. Ani's able to fight this one off, foul to the right, and the count will hold at 1-2.
That's a nice job of staying alive. A two-strike breaking ball just out of the zone. He was able to put enough on it to get another pitch.
Swing and a little tapper. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Another one sent foul. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Kipnis trying to get there. He can't get there as it falls in. And the run will score as the Rangers strike first to lead it 1-0.
Well, Matt, they're getting to him early. First inning run, RBI on that base hit. Take it to him because you know once he settles in, he's going to dominate the game.
Stepping in now, Adrian Beltre. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Nobody out, runner on first. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Time to take a look at the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Mike Fillmore.
Now, Fillmore's an interesting case. I call him one of those guys that calls the corners. A little wider, but up and down, he's not giving you much. So if you just put a little square up there, that's him.
Swing and a miss by Beltre for strike three as he's retired.
Batting fourth, second baseman.
Stepping in, Rougned Odor. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. Not in time. He's in there at second. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. And this is going to be a foul ball. Hard sinker misses 2-2. One out and a runner on second base. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Into the box now, Nomar Mazara. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And this is fouled at the plate. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And that one stayed too low, apparently.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Full count, here it comes. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Next pitch will be number 24 in this long first inning. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. And next will be the versatile Tyler Naquin. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Here it comes on 1-1. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
He had some really good late action on that slider right there. It's hard to do anything with that pitch unless you're sitting on it and catch it out front before it breaks all the way in.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Swung on in the dirt. Strike three. Lucroy has it, and he makes the throw to first. Naquin is retired, and there's one away.
Third baseman.
Digging in the switch hitter, Jose Ramirez. He'll swing it from the left side right here. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Hit out towards second. In time to first, and there are two away.
Batting eight, the right fielder, number eight, Lonnie Chisenhall.
Stepping into the box, Lonnie Chisenhall. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The pitch. This is skied into short left center. On the move is Gomez. He makes the play. A great catch on the run to retire the side. Indians go down 1-2-3. They trail this one 1-0. In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
Batting seventh, right fielder, Shin Soo Choo.
At the plate, Shin Soo Choo, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. One out, nobody on. Good sinker that time as he gets a piece and chops it foul at home plate. He'll try again, 1-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, James Loney. And he puts it on the ground to second. Taken in by Kipnis. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired.
Nice bounce back.
Rangers set down in order. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. And he's a perfect 3-for-3. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Way in front of a great slider that time. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Oh, he might have got away with one. Two-strike breaking ball that ended up being in the zone. I think he probably wanted that out of the zone, but fortunately, he just fouled it off.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Calling for it, Coyne. He's got it one away.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Ready for another chance? Michael Brantley, 1-for-1 after a single his first time up. Bases are empty, one man out. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
A lot of base hits up the middle. Set your sights up the alleys and try to take now it back batting. Up the middle hard like Good he did stuff. Right here. Nice job.
Francisco Lindor.
If Michael Brantley can have some performances in real life like he's having tonight, the Indians are going to be okay this year, I think. But it'll depend on more than that, but it'll be a big reason why.
In now, Francisco Lindor. Slice down the left side, but foul. Runners on first with one down. And he got him.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
Standing in now, Edwin Encarnacion taking all the way, and it's 3-1 now. Liner towards short, but this will find the shortstop's glove for the third out of the inning. One left for the Tribe. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. At the plate, Jared Hoying will lead things off here for the Rangers, to be followed by Elvis Andrus on deck. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swings through it for strike number two. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Anytime you get rookies just breaking into the big leagues, you have to expect a certain amount of this. There aren't any easy at-bats at this level, and you really have to learn how to slow the game down in your head because everything feels like it's so much faster up here.
Stepping in now, Elvis Andrus. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. Line toward right center. And that will be a base hit for Andrus. Around first, digging for two. Elvis is still going. He's headed for third. And he's in there at third with a one-out triple.
Wow, he's getting his daily conditioning in during the game. That's his second triple, so obviously he's seeing the ball great, and he's showing he knows how to motor around the bases just fine.
Bad route to the ball by Naquin there. Wow. I'll have to keep an eye on that.
So a definite RBI spot here. Runner at third, one away. And standing in, the speedy Carlos Gomez. One out and a runner on third. And a fastball just a bit high.
With the infield back and a runner at third, he's definitely pitching for a strikeout or maybe something like a harmless pop-up. You could see it from that high fastball, but that was just a good job of laying off that pitch.
Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Just a tick behind for a strike. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Ramirez is over. Two down.
Almost didn't catch that one.
The third baseman, number 29, Adrian Beltre.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Set. Here's the 3-2. Grounder down the line at third. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. A Another full count pitch home. And another foul ball. Ready now with the payoff pitch. And he missed with it there. Ball four. It's a two-out walk with the runner still at third.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count. It just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Rougned Odor. Two on, two out for him here in the third. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Not much to say about that swing other than it should have never happened.
Trying to keep the score where it is and the pitch. And he fights this one off here to foul it off to the left, and that holds the count at 1-2. Runners on first and third, two away. Again, he sends it out of play.
Boy, but another strikeout here would be huge for Kluber. Let's see.
A swing and a miss at a sinker. The strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Rangers leave a pair, but they hold a 1-0 lead. In is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. He's 0-1 thus far. Set to deliver on 2-1. Seared down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Chris Colabella.
Striding in once again, Chris Colabella comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ball game. Set and the 1-1 pitch. And a whiff at a good slider that time. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Skied into straightaway right. Settling under it now is Chu, and he makes the catch for out number two.
Now batting, the center fielder, Tyler Naquin.
And next will be the versatile Tyler Naquin. 0-1 for him here in this one. And now a pitch on the way. And a fastball not close. It's 2-1 now. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Hard hit to first. On to first with it is Loney, and the inning is over. So they go quietly here in this half inning. To the bottom of inning number four we go. The Rangers lead this one 1-0. In now the power hitting outfielder Nomar Mazzara. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. 0-2, here it comes. And this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and that'll hold the count at 0-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away.
That was a good job tying him up inside on that strikeout pitch. It wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with two strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
Into the box, Jonathan Lucroy. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his 8th punch out of the ballgame.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Digging in to try it again, Shin-Soo Chu. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. tapper up the line. That winds up foul. One run on three hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Digging in for his second at-bat, Jose Ramirez. He's 0 for 1 thus far. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. On the ground, up the middle. Scooped up on the backhand. And the throw will not be in time, as I don't think he was going to get him anyway, but a fine effort nonetheless.
Fielder, number 8, Lonnie Chisenhall.
In now, Lonnie Chisenhall. Pitch outside, the throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. So they still haven't picked up an extra base hit in this one, but that stolen base at least gets him a guy in scoring position.
Yeah, and I think that's exactly what the manager was thinking there, Matt. Hey, if we aren't driving the ball with any authority today, we need to make something happen in a different way. They only need a single to the outfield now to push a run across.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Squared that one up just a little late. Payoff pitch one more time. Inside as he nearly got him, and it's ball 4.
Huge innings have begun with much less, I can tell you that.
Now batting.
First and second, no out, and the guy on the bump really needs a strikeout or a double play right here.
So striding in, Yan Gomes, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. Full count. Here it comes. Line to the right side, but a foul ball. Count is full. Here's the pitch. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Here's Michael Brantley. Couple of singles to his credit thus far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. And he pops up the bunt attempt. Darvish is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Now batting, shortstop, Francisco.
So here's Francisco Lindor now. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Hard hit ball to second. Odor has it on to first, and the Tribe are held in check as the inning is over. James Loney will be our leadoff man when we come back. Last half of the fifth coming up. Texas is out in front, 1-0. Here's the first baseman, James Loney. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How do they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Yeah. 3-0 pitch on its way. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch-outs and working on number five.
Swing and a miss. Five straight strikeouts now, and there's one gone.
A lot of indecision there on that check swing, and that's something you see quite a lot on 3-2. When the difference between striking out and drawing a walk can be an inch or two, it's pretty understandable why guys aren't always aggressive with their swings.
Into the box now, Jared Hoying. Ripped down the line, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. One run on three hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. And he'll continue this roll he's on. Make it six strikeouts in a row. Gracious, two away.
The shortstop, number one, Elvis.
Digging in and looking for more, Elvis Andrus. He's tripled twice already in this ball game. One pitch is a sinker taken for a strike, 1-2.
Well, he's done a great job on the hill throughout this game, and it's something to be proud of anytime you can pitch a good game in this ballpark, especially when it's not your home ballpark.
Seven in a row. Flat out dominant, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Rangers, but they're up 1-0. Now he singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Oh, and a big swing by Encarnacion as this is sent out to deep left field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. First home run of the campaign for him. And with it, the Indians have leveled the score at one apiece. That home run is definitely worth giving the show track treatment to. And as we look at it, not only an impressive distance shot, but the 110 miles an hour exit velocity is nothing to scoff at either. That's a big boy home run. Standing in now, Jason Kipnis. Saws him off here as this ball is popped into the air. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down.
First baseman, Chris Colabella.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Chris Colabella. One run in and one gone so far this inning. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
This inning didn't get started the way he hoped with that home run, but I've got to give him credit for flushing it and coming back here to get strikeouts on the last two guys. He's acting like it didn't even happen before.
Stepping in now, Tyler Naquin. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Point. Has it in his tracks, and that's the third out. But thanks to this solo shot, the Tribe is back to tie things up. On to the bottom of the sixth. All even now at 1-1. Here's Carlos Gomez. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Swing and a liner. And this inning starts with a solid base hit. And he'll get in there standing up with a leadoff double.
Oh, this is a great way to start the inning. Now the go-ahead run is on second. A base hit away from coming across. I know it's only the sixth inning, but you'd love to claim the lead right now and let your bullpen carry the load the rest of the way.
Striding in once again, Adrian Beltre comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
No one out with conference at the mound here.
The runner at second. Now time is called here as we'll get a trip to the mound. Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing. Sinker, and that's ruled strike two. Sinker, 3-2 now. Rougned Odor waits on deck. A runner at second, nobody out. Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Now a ball line foul as this is over the Rangers dugout. Looking for the K. Here's the pitch. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still full at 3-2. The next 3-2. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Brantley going back, and that one is out of here. A two-run shot that gives them the lead.
Yeah, play the game, dude.
So it's a two-run homer for Adrian Beltre. First home run of the campaign for him, and it gives the Rangers a 3-1 lead.
I can tell you one thing. You might get away with throwing a ball in that location in the minor leagues, but when you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got. A really bad result.
Into the box, Rougned Odor. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Well, that was unexpected. You're looking for that sinker down. He throws a fastball up. Now he's just changed the game on you. He's forcing you to look somewhere else.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Wow, it just doesn't seem like he's being as aggressive as he was before he gave up that home run. Was throwing the ball great. Now it seems like he's a little bit more tentative throwing the ball across the plate.
Hit out towards second. Kipton is showing off his range. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
Now batting, designated hitter, Nomar Mazara.
Digging in once again, Nomar Mazara. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Looking to send him packing again. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. One out, nobody on. Here's Kipnis now, the second baseman. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Now batting, catcher, Jonathan Lucroy.
In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And flirting with danger on a changeup that missed high for a ball. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Shin-Soo Chu would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Another payoff pitch. And he's got another one. 13 strikeouts now, and the inning is over. But two here in the Rangers half of the inning, and they come on this two-run home run. Bottom third of the order, 7-8-9, due up to start the seventh. It's now 3-1, Texas. Welcome back to Arlington. The Rangers on top in this one as we get a look at our game summary through the first six innings of play. Matt Busch is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 51. Back. Forward.
Ready for another shot now. Jose Ramirez, 1-for-2 on his line so far. One-two pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Coyne moves over. One out.
The right fielder, number 8, Lonnie Chisenhall.
Lonnie Chisenhall will stand in. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And now the Ranger bullpen swings into action. A lefty and a right-hander are throwing down there. Hit back up the middle. Andrus has it. Throw gets him. Two down.
Now batting.
Hey, not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
Ready once again, Yan Gomes. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. That fastball is too much for him there. 1-2. Well, I think his eyes lit up when he saw that pitch coming up at his eye level.
Oh, you think? If you've got a good fastball like he does, that location can be really effective. It looks so tempting to the hitter, but making contact on that pitch can be very tough.
Curveball that time, not even close.
I think if he executes that pitch on the corner instead of off of it, he probably gets some pretty weak contact, if anything. He jammed him pretty hard on the previous pitch, so my bet was he was going to try to cheat on the inside part, thinking it might be coming again.
Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Shin-Soo Chu will lead things off after the break. It's the Rangers 3 and the Indians 1. Boone Logan is out from the bullpen as he'll get his first work of the season here on opening night.
Boone Logan.
Shin-Soo Chu at the plate now. 0 for 2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. The 3-2 one more time. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box now, James Loney. And this is chopped foul near the plate, and the count will move to 1-2 now. Just tried to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Lindor ranging up the middle. And the throw here is going to get him at first. Excellent range there at short, and there are two away now.
Jared Hoying.
Here's Jared Hoying, and he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate. And the count holds at 2-2. Swing and a liner. But this will be foul. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Rangers set down in order as the lead remains 3-1. Jake Diekman is out from the bullpen as he'll get his first work of the season here on opening night.
Diekman.
Here's Michael Brantley. He's looking for hit number 3 here in this at-bat. Set. Here comes the 1-1. Pulled toward right center field. Gomez will back up and put this away for a long out number one. So a nice running catch on display that time as we get a look at it again with Showtrack. He took a nice route, covered a good amount of ground, 100 feet to be exact, to bring that one in. Well done. In now, Francisco Lindor. Chopped foul right at home plate. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Swing and a flare hit toward right. Chu coming on. He gets to it and, oh, he botched it. The relay. The tag, and he's nabbed trying for two.
The batter, number 10. Designated hitter, Edwin Encarnacion.
Edwin Encarnacion now. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point. Eighth inning of this low-scoring affair. 3-1 our score. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Ready on 1-2. Hot shot on the ground is short. There is Andrus. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. Down in order go the Tribe. Score holds. It's 3-1. Dan Otero is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 61, Dan Otero.
Digging in to try it again, Elvis Andrus. He's tripled twice already in this ball game. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. The 1-2 pitch. Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Here it comes now to Andrus. And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. Again, a 1-2. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Ready with two balls and a strike. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Digging in and looking for more, Adrian Beltre. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Takes a look at a slider that catches the inside corner. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Rangers, and it's still 3-1. Back here in the Lone Star State with Major League Baseball on MLB Network. Set to start the ninth inning in this one. Sam Dyson takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. In is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
Here it is. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Point going back on it. Gone to lead off the inning. It's a solo homer here for Jason Kipnis. First home run of the campaign for him, and the Tribe have made this a 3-2 score now.
Friends, is a cardinal sin for any closer. You can't give up the long ball. Good thing for him, he still has the lead. We'll see now if he can rebound and actually keep it.
Gonna bring in Carlos Santana, I do believe, yep.
Carlos Santana will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Carlos Santana.
Base is empty here with nobody out. Hit hard up the middle. Andrus fields it cleanly on the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. It was a fastball right down the middle, and he hit it hard, but he couldn't elevate it at all. Would have been a different story if he did.
And next will be the versatile Tyler Naquin. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Set. Here's the 3-1. And that pitch catches the inside corner. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a liner. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Boy, that was a heck of an at-bat. Worked the count full. Pitcher thought for sure he'd be looking fastball. He got a breaking ball, stayed with it, and got the base hit. That's about as good as it's going to get right there.
Stepping in now, Jose Ramirez. And he takes a cold strike, too.
Matt, here we are. Double play situation, and everybody knows he's got that sinker. Maybe get a ground ball and get two, right? But he comes with the fastball right there. Now nobody knows what to see. This is going to be an interesting at-bat.
A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Keone Kella gets the call here as he'll try and look for one out to finish this thing off. Lonnie Chisenhall will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at. First and two away. Austin Jackson will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Austin Jackson.
Two out with the man at first. Swing and a miss, and now the Tribe finds themselves down to their last strike.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
A crowd nearing 50,000 on its feet here in Arlington. And he struck him out for out number three. So that'll wrap things up here as they leave the possible tying run stranded at first.
Well, maybe a little bit of a problem is they had to wind up going to that bullpen quite a bit. Five pitchers are going to combine to finish this one to get the win.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Yu Darvish gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Corey Kluber struck out 13 in the losing effort. So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Harold Reynolds and Dan Plesak, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB Network. Good night, everybody.
Final line score for our ball game tonight.
Okay, so a disappointing loss, but if I wouldn't have made as many base running mistakes as I did, And Corey Kluber wouldn't have given up that home run. Maybe I would have given myself a little bit of a better chance here. Let's go ahead here and get back to... Oh, I got a reward, huh? Not a great one, but okay. Alright. So, what our plan here was going to be to try and get through this series. Unfortunately, I am kind of out of time for right now. So what we'll do here for our next episode is we will quick manage the rest of this series and get through the Arizona series as well, and pick back up again later on with the White Sox and Tigers. But again, I just kind of wanted to get through this game, this opening game. It's an unfortunate one, loss, but one nonetheless. So again, we'll do some quick managing on our next deck, on our next episode of Cleveland Indians franchise. Thanks for joining us. The final score of our first Cleveland Indians franchise, the Indians take a loss to the Texas Rangers by a final score of 3-2. So long, everybody.